Dear students, it is the lecture number 13 on the chapter Determinants. In the previous session, we have discussed how to find out the adjoint of a matrix and also solved some of the examples. In this session, I am going to discuss singular and non-singular matrix. After that, we will see the inverse of a given square matrix. So, definition. A square matrix A is said to be singular if determinant of A is equal to 0. So whenever the determinant value is equal to 0, then that square matrix A is said to be singular matrix. Similarly, here we will see the definition for non-singular matrix. A square matrix A is said to be non-singular if determinant of A is not equal to 0. Means which should be other than 0, it may be positive or negative. Therefore, a square matrix A is said to be non-singular if determinant of A is not equal to 0. So, these are the definitions for singular and non-singular matrix. Here we will see some of the results. If A and B are non-singular matrices of the same order, then the products AB and BA are also non-singular matrices of the same order. So please remember this, student. Here, whenever they are non-singular, two matrices A and B are non-singular, then AB and BA are also non-singular matrices of the same order. We will see some more result. Result 2. If A and B are square matrices of the same order, then the determinant of AB that can be written as the product of determinant of A and determinant of B. So this is also the important result. And the next result, 3. If A is a non-singular square matrix of order n, then determinant of adjoint of A is equal to determinant of A to the power n minus 1. So this is the very important property. So let us see the proof of this property here. Consider a square matrix A of order 3, A into adjoint of A is equal to determinant of A into I. Let I be an identity matrix of order 3, A into adjoint of A is equal to determinant of A into the identity matrix. I means it is the identity matrix. See, student, here this property A into adjoint of A is equal to determinant of A into I. This is also equal to adjoint of A into A. So this is already the property which we have discussed in the previous video. Therefore, we can consider that property here. Now that determinant of A into the identity matrix of order 3. So that consists the elements 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Now we can multiply this determinant of A to all the elements because it is a matrix. It is not a determinant. It is a matrix. So that whenever you are going to multiply any scalar, so that we can multiply to all the elements, then this matrix becomes, that is matrix of determinant of A 0, 0, 0, determinant of A 0, 0, 0, determinant of A. Now, students, we can take determinant of A common from here. First, we have to take down the determinant on both sides. That A into adjoint of A, that whole determinant will be the product of determinant of A into determinant of adjoint of A. So, we have applied that property here. This is equal to, the matrix can be converted into the determinant here by applying the determinant. Therefore, the determinant of A 0, 0, 0, determinant of A 0, 0, 0, determinant of A. So, it is here the property applied on the LHS part. Now, here we can write this one by taking determinant of A common from each row. Each row means, here from the first row we can take determinant of A, from the second row we can take determinant of A, from the third row also we can take out determinant of A, so that we have to take three times. Therefore, here we can write in the next step determinant of a whole cube, because we have taken thrice from the first row, second row, third row. Therefore, determinant of a whole to the power 3 into the remaining determinant is 100 010 001. Therefore, we have determinant of a cube into 1, means the value of determinant of identity matrix is always equal to 1. Therefore, we have determinant of A into adjoint of A, determinant of adjoint of A is equal to determinant of A to the power 3 into 1. Therefore, we can write this one as determinant of adjoint of A is equal to determinant of A square, because we can cancel that one term here, because on that LHS part we have determinant of A, so we can transfer and cancel this one. The power becomes 2. Here note point, if A is non-singular square matrix of order 3 by 3, then determinant of A is equal to adjoint square is equal to determinant of adjoint of A. Therefore, this is the property applied here. Therefore, determinant of adjoint of A is equal to always equal to determinant of A to the power n minus 1. Therefore, n is what? That is order of the given square matrix. Now, we will see the concept of inverse of a matrix. Definition for inverse of a matrix. Let capital A be a square matrix of order n. Then, there exists a square matrix B of order n such that AB is equal to BA is equal to I, then B is the inverse of A. See student, here whenever we have the product of two matrices which is equal to I means what it is here, the identity matrix of the same order, then here that A is said to be as inverse of B and B is said to be as inverse of A. Therefore, the product of the matrix and its inverse is equal to the identity matrix. So, this is the definition for the inverse matrix of the given matrix. And it is denoted by capital B here. So, that also be written as here A to the power minus 1. So, this is called as A inverse or inverse of the matrix A. Now, formula for A inverse, we can find out here. We know that A into adjoint of A is equal to adjoint of A into A is equal to determinant of A into I. Now divide throughout by determinant of A, which is not equal to 0, means which should be non-singular matrix. Therefore, we can divide this whole equation by determinant of A. Therefore, we have A into adjoint of A divided by determinant of A is equal to adjoint of A into A divided by determinant of A is equal to, that is I, because we have divided by determinant of A. Therefore, determinant of A will be cancelled in the numerator also. Now, by comparing this one with AB is equal to BA is equal to I. So, from the previous equation, we have that B is equal to adjoint of A divided by determinant of A. Already, I have given in the previous slide that B can also be written as A inverse, means the inverse of the matrix A, which is also equal to adjoint of A divided by determinant of A. Therefore, this is the formula for finding the inverse of matrix A. And where here that determinant of A should not be equal to 0, means determinant of A here means that A is always non-singular matrix, then only we can find out the inverse for that matrix. Note, a square matrix A is said to be invertible if and only if A is non-singular. Already I have given the statement here that a square matrix A is said to be invertible, means if you want to find out inverse of that matrix, so that should be a non-singular matrix. Let us consider example now. If A is an invertible matrix of order 2, then determinant of A inverse is equal to first option determinant of A, B option 1 divided by determinant of A, C option 1, D option 0. Here we can find out the right option by taking A into A inverse is equal to I. Here already we know that the product of the matrix and its inverse is equal to identity matrix. Now apply the determinant on both sides. So this product, mean determinant of this product will be written here, and here that I, this is the identity matrix. For that also we have applied here that determinant. Now the determinant of AB can be written as determinant of A into determinant of B. Similarly, we can write determinant of A into A inverse is determinant of A into determinant of A inverse is equal to determinant of I is always equal to 1. Means the determinant of identity matrix is always equal to 1. Now using this one here, we have got these values here. This implies determinant of A inverse is equal to, here we can transfer this term to the right hand side, then it becomes divided by, therefore 1 divided by determinant of A. Therefore we have determinant of A inverse is always equal to 1 by determinant of A. Therefore that B option is right option, and the correct option is B. We will see next example. Find the inverse of the matrix if it exists capital A is equal to the matrix 2 minus 2 4 3. So we have to find out the inverse of the matrix if it exists. Means we have to check out whether the given matrix is singular or non-singular. If it is non-singular, then only we can find out the inverse for that particular matrix. Solution. For that, let us find out the determinant of the given matrix first. Determinant of A is equal to determinant of 2 minus 2, 4, 3. Now we can simplify this one. 2 into 3 is 6 minus of 4 into minus 2 is minus 8. It becomes plus 8. Therefore, 6 plus 8 is equal to 14, which is not equal to 0. Therefore, the given matrix is non-singular. Therefore, A inverse exists. Let us find out the cofactors of each element of A here. The cofactors of A are, here we can find out the cofactors by using the formula capital Aij is the cofactor of the element small aij, that is equal to minus 1 to the power I plus j into Mij. Mij means that is minor of the element small ai. Therefore, we can find out the cofactors of the matrix A are cofactor of A11 for this element. For this element, here we have to delete here first row and first column. Therefore, the minor of this element is 3, and by using this formula, we have the sign plus. Therefore, 3 is the cofactor of this first element. Next, capital A12 means the cofactor of this second element minus 2. Therefore, for that, we have the minor 4. And by using this formula, we have that minus sign. So minus of 4, so that will be equal to minus 4. And next, A21 for the third element, we have to find out the cofactor. So we have to delete the first column and second row here. Therefore, we have that minus 2 is minor for this element. And we have the sign minus here, because by using the formula we have I plus j is means it is 2 1 2 1, means we have this is 3 here, so we have the sign minus. Minus of minus 2 becomes plus 2. Next, capital A22 means that is cofactor of the element, this fourth element 3. So for that we have the minor 2, and by using this formula means 2 plus 2 here it is positive. Therefore, we have the minor is 2. 2 into plus 1 is equal to 2 only. So these are the cofactors of the given matrix A. Now let us take here cofactor matrix, that is equal to The matrix of 3 minus 4, 2, 2. Now find out the adjoint of A. That adjoint of A is equal to the transpose of a cofactor matrix. Right. Therefore, we can transpose this one to find out adjoint of A. We have the first row becomes first column and second row becomes second column. Therefore, we have 3 minus 4, 2, 2. The transpose of this one becomes 3 minus 4 in the first column, 2, 2 in the second column. So, this is the value of adjoint of A. Next, we have to find out A inverse. That A inverse is equal to adjoint of A divided by determinant of A. Or else we can read it as 1 by determinant of A whole into that adjoint of A. That adjoint of A, here we got the matrix and determinant of A value is already 14. So 1 by 14 into the adjoint of A is what here? 3, 2 minus 4, 2. And divide all those elements by this 14. Therefore, we have 3 by 14, 2 by 14, minus 4 by 14 and 2 by 14. Now, we can cancel some of the elements here. Therefore, we have 3 by 14, 1 by 7, minus 2 by 7 and 1 by 7. So, this is the required inverse of the given matrix. Similarly, we go for one more example. Question: find the inverse of the matrix if it exists. Capital A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 0, 2, 4, 0, 0, 5. Let us verify, is it singular or non-singular? For that, we have to find out the value of the given determinant of this given matrix. Therefore, determinant of A is equal to the whole determinant of 1, 2, 3, 0, 2, 4, 0, 0, 5. Now, we can find out the value of the determinant. Therefore, consider 1. We have the signs here, plus minus plus here. So first we have the sign plus. 1 into 2 into 5 is 10, minus 0 into 4 is 0. And for the second element, we have the sign minus. And delete the first row and second column. We have the element is 2 here. 2 into the bracket of 0 minus 0, 0 minus 0. And for the third element, we have the sign plus. And delete the first row and third column. We have the element is 3 into 0 minus 0. Therefore, we have that is 1 into 10 is equal to 10. Remaining, these two elements are becoming here 0 only. Therefore, the value of determinant A is equal to 10, which is not equal to 0. Therefore, that given matrix A is a non-singular matrix. Therefore, A inverse exists. Let us find out the cofactors of this given matrix. Let us find the cofactors of each element of A here. Therefore, by using this formula, Aij is equal to minus 1 to the power I plus j into capital Mij. A11, so therefore here 1 plus 1 becomes here 2, so minus 1 to the power 2 is plus only, and we have the remaining determinant by deleting the first and first column. We have that is 2 into 5 is 10, minus 0 into 4 is 0. Therefore, we have 10 minus 0 is equal to 10. Next, we have A12, therefore 1 plus 2 is 3, therefore this is odd, therefore it is negative here. Now we can delete the first row and second column. We have that is 0 minus 0. Therefore, A12 is equal to 0 only. Next, A13 for that element we have 1 plus 3 means it is 4. Therefore, minus 1 to the power 4 is equal to again positive only. Now for that element we have to find the cofactor, that is the remaining determinant 0 minus 0. Therefore, we have 0 only. Next, A21, for this element we have 2 plus 1 is 3, therefore it is again negative only. The remaining determinant is what here? 2 into 5 is 10, minus 0 into 3 is 0 only. Therefore, minus 10 is the cofactor of the element small A21. Next, A22, for that we have 2 plus 2 means it is positive only. Therefore, the remaining determinant is here 1 into 5 is 5, minus 0 into 3 is 0. Therefore, we have this is phi, therefore it is phi is the cofactor of small a23. Not a23, 2 plus 3 means it is odd, therefore minus 1 to the power 5 is again minus, therefore minus into the bracket of the remaining determinant by deleting the second row and third column, we have 0 minus 0, therefore it is again here minus of 0, means again it is 0 only. Next a31, so 3 plus 1 is again even, therefore the sign is positive, therefore we can delete the third row and first column, the remaining determinant is 2 into 4 is 8, minus 2 into 3 is 6, therefore 8 minus 6 is equal to 2. Next a32, therefore 3 plus 2 is 5, therefore the sign is minus, and remaining determinant by deleting the third row and second column, we have 1 into 4 is 4, minus 0 into 3 is 0 only, so 4 minus 0 means minus of 4 minus 0 is again minus 4, and next the last cofactor is a33, so 3 plus 3 is again that is 1 only, so minus 1 to the power 6 means that is here positive. The remaining determinant value is 1 into 2 is 2, minus 0 into 2 is 0, therefore here 2 minus 0 is 2, therefore these are the cofactors of each element of the given the matrix capital A. Therefore the cofactor matrix can be written as 10 0 0 minus 10 5 0 and 2 minus 4 2. Now we can find out the adjoint of A, so which is the co, that is transpose of cofactor matrix, therefore we have adjoint of A is equal to that is 10 0 0 minus 10 5 0 2 minus 4 2, the transpose of this one will be equal to 10 0 0 in the first column, minus 10 5 0 in the second column, 2 minus 4 2 in the third column. Now we can find out the value of A inverse. Therefore, A inverse is equal to 1 by determinant of A into adjoint of A. Therefore, adjoint of A is already the matrix and determinant of A value is 10. So, 1 divided by 10 into the adjoint of A. We have already, we have this matrix here. Now, we can divide all those elements by using 10 here because it is 1 divided by 10. Therefore, we have 1 minus 1 by cancelling 1 by 5 and 0, 1 by 2 minus 2 by 5 by cancelling and 0, 0, 1 by 5. So, this is the required inverse of the given matrix. Similarly, we will go for some more these type of examples based on the inverse of matrix in the next video. Therefore, we will see in the some more examples in the next video. Today, I am going to end this session. Thank you, students.